Hello and welcome to Daily Current Affairs by Neo IAS. Today is 24th April 2019 and the topic we are going to discuss is Traditional Knowledge Digital Library, Sexual Assault Evidence Collection Kits, Mosquirix, Global Talent Competitiveness Index, Map-Aided Program. We are continuing with Marginal Seas and the countries surrounding it and the previous year question revision series. Coming to the first topic, that's a Traditional Knowledge Digital Library, TKDL. So, this is in news because there was a memorandum of understanding signed between the Ayush Ministry and the CSIR. So, what they are doing is, they are conducting research and education in the areas of traditional system of medicine and they are integrating it with the modern science and creating a library of it. Okay, so they together developed it because they wanted to create an Indian system of medicine in order to control or avoid biopiracy and misappropriation of India's traditional knowledge network. Okay, knowledge, whatever is there traditionally. So, they don't want biopiracy happening in that system. So, they created a database. Basically, it's a knowledge about the medicinal plants and their formulas of the Indian system. Okay, so this is happening for the first time. It's a pioneer initiative in order to compact or prevent the misappropriation, whatever is happening in the International Patent Offices, IPO. So, it's a collaborative of CSIR and Ayush, as I already told you. So, it will bridge act as a bridge between the traditional information in India and also the patent examiner. So, they will bridge the patent examiners at IPO, that's the International Patent Office, and the traditional knowledge information which is there in India. Okay, so they are compiling the information or the knowledge in basic languages of India like Sanskrit, Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada, Arabic, Persian and Urdu. So, these are the ancient texts where you get the knowledge. So, they have been compiled in these traditional languages. So, this will be like inaccessible and incomprehensible for the examiners overseas because they don't know our language. Okay, so this is the TKDL is basically situated in Ghaziabad in UP. They will have the information about Ayurveda, Unani, Siddha, Yoga. All of them are given in the digitized format. Okay, so they cannot access the information because they are in the traditional language of Indian culture. So what they do is they actually translate into five foreign languages. One is Japanese, English, Spanish, German and French. Okay, so this will be like a knowledge based conversion where the data it is abstracted and is converted into several languages. They are using some code. Okay, code or metadata methodology or certain methodology in order to convert this knowledge into the foreign language. Okay, this will like ensure a near foolproof security for the resources or the data we are sharing. Okay, so that is how it is done. It is in Ghaziabad, UP. Okay, the next topic is Sexual Assault Evidence Collection Kits, SAEK. Okay, so this is an initiative of Ministry of Home Affairs. So, what they do is they provide kits to collect blood and semen samples where there is a sexual assault has happened. So, this will help to like immediately collect the investigation samples without destroying it. Okay, the evidence is not getting destroyed if you have this kit. So, the sexual assault evidence collection kit, or it is also called as a rape investigation kits. So, this is designed to collect the medical or legal investigation things immediately after the assault has or the rape case has happened. Like blood and semen samples in case of sexual assault or rape cases. So, this kit will like help the enforcement agency to ensure that there is effective investigation happening before for better prosecution and convictions in sexual assault cases. So, they are using this kits or they are implementing this kits using the Nirbhaya fund which was formed in 2012 after the Delhi gang rape case. So, okay, I personally feel here that the Nirbhaya fund should be used for the safety and security of women. So, it should be used rather in cases where there a rape should not happen. okay, this is like rape happens, and after rape, what should you, what you have to be done? So I am totally against it, because I personally feel that it should be stopped. Not like after happening, we have to do something. Yeah, we have to definitely do, but there should be more plans in order to actually stop the rape cases or sexual assault cases. The fund should be actively used for the things that should not happen. After happening, anyways, we can't do anything about it. Only thing is effective investigation. Thus, this rape investigation kit can be helpful. So, that is my personal opinion. If you have any personal opinion, please comment it in the comment section. We'll have a debate on it. So, the kit contains test tubes and bottles, and they'll also have this instructions about how to collect the evidence from the crime scene, and how can you reach this to the closest laboratory, and there the test will be done. Okay, within 2 months. And talking about the Nirbhaya fund, I told you it is from Nirbhaya fund. It is like a dedicated fund for initiative like this, for the safety and security of women in the country. So this is under Finance Ministry. This has been included in Union Budget since 2013. So it's basically initial corpus of 1000 crore is there in the fund. And it works under the Ministry of Women and Child Development. They are the nodal ministry. Even though the fund is under Finance Ministry, created under Finance Ministry, the nodal agency is Ministry of Women and Child Development. And the ministry, they review and monitor the progress of various schemes that has been done under the fund. Because it's a non-lapsable corpus fund. It's very important. It's non-lapsable. Okay. And there is an empowered committee of officers. It is under the Secretary of Women and Child Development. They will be monitoring the schemes which is coming under the Nirbhaya fund. And this committee, it's an inter-ministerial committee. Like the Nirbhaya fund, it's not like it belongs to one particular ministry. No. All the ministry, many of the ministry have schemes under Nirbhaya fund. So this empowered committee of officers will be like a inter-ministerial committee. So there will be a different ministry representation which is implementing the scheme under Nirbhaya fund. They will be monitoring it. Okay. The next topic is Mosquirix. Mosquirix is a vaccine. Okay. It's a vaccine. It is about to be tested as a part of routine, that's childhood immunization. So it is like for the first time it is implementing in Ghana, Kenya and Malawi. So it's a pilot program, and it is considered the first malarial vaccine that's been discovered for more than 30 years ago. Okay, and it is also the first to be active against a human parasite. So what is malaria actually? It's a vector borne disease, and it is caused by protozoans, parasitic protozoans. That's a plasmodium type of protozoans. Okay, so it is commonly transmitted by infected female anopheles mosquito. Very important, female anopheles mosquito. And in India, it has been caused by two parasites. One is Plasmodium falciparum, that is PF, and the Plasmodium vivax, that's a PV. Okay, the Plasmodium falciparum, it is found in the forest areas, and the Plasmodium vivax, it is found in the plain area. And malaria, it is mainly concentrated in the regions like Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, then Meghalaya, Mizoram, Tripura. Okay, so because, you know, once if there is a monsoon, after monsoon, the post-monsoon time, many areas like this will be cut off from the main region. Okay, and there will be like very efficient vectors also in that region. Such areas are very malaria prone areas in India. Okay, so annual malaria parasite incidence, API, there's a measurement like that. It is a parameter, it is used to measure malaria in an area. Now, how much malarial incidents are happening in an area. Okay. The next is Global Talent Competitiveness Index. This is in news because India got 80th rank in this year's 2019 year's index. So, Global Talent Competitiveness Index, it has been done by INSEAD, ADICO Group and Tata Communications. So, they are actually measuring the ability of countries to compete for talent. It has two parts, like It is like an input-output based method, okay? They will actually measure the input as well as the output. I'll tell you what input methods are. Like, the input means countries' effort in producing and acquiring talent. They are producing and acquiring talent. And whatever is happening as a result of the production of acquisition of talent, that is the output. They measure both input and output. Okay. And the theme for this year, the 6th edition of GTCI, is entrepreneurial talent and global competitiveness. Okay. It was launched for the first time in 2013. And the report covered like 125 economies and 114 cities. Okay. Now coming to the map aided program. So I have Baltic Sea there. So UPSC has a habit of asking marginal seas, because they are asked for Mediterranean Sea in two consecutive years very recently. So don't take it light. Marginal seas are very important. Okay. So I am talking about Baltic Sea. Baltic Sea is again a marginal sea in Atlantic Ocean. So it is enclosed by Denmark, Estonia, Finland, Latvia, Lithuania, Sweden, Germany, Poland, Russia. Okay, so it is connected to North Sea as well as White Sea. White Sea, it is connected to White Sea via White Sea Canal, that's an artificial canal. And it is connected to North Sea via Kiel Canal. Okay, now I'll show you Baltic Sea. See, this is Baltic Sea, and the country surrounding it is Sweden, Finland, then you have Russia, then Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, then you have Poland, then Germany, then Denmark. See, that is the surrounding countries of Baltic Sea. You have three major gulfs there. One is Gulf of Bothnia between Sweden and Finland. Then you have Gulf of Finland between Finland, Russia and Estonia. Then you have one more gulf, that is Gulf of Riga between Estonia and Latvia. Okay, so you have a total of four water bodies to study here: Baltic Sea, Gulf of Bothnia, Gulf of Finland and Gulf of Riga. Okay, so that's an important location in the Scandinavian region of Europe. Coming to the previous year question revision series, Reserve Bank of India, that's RBI, act as a banker's bank. This would imply which of the following? Others bank retain their deposit with RBI. The RBI lends fund to the commercial bank in need, in times of need. The RBI advises the commercial bank on the monetary matters. So, the first statement, banks retain their deposit with RBI, definitely. It is why it is called as a banker's bank. And one more time, if they need money, they can ask RBI. That is why again it is called as a banker's bank. But look at the third statement, guys. RBI advises the commercial banks on monetary matters. They do. That's a right statement. But in context of question, what is the question here? RBI act as a banker's bank. So we have to address the question. If all the three statements are considered, all the three statements are correct only. But we have to address the question. The question is, it acts as a banker's bank, which would imply, which statement would imply it. So, it is the first and second statement. It will hold their deposit, it can lend. But advising it, does not come under the definition of banker's bank. So, the answer is 1 and 2. Okay, so that's all for today, guys. I hope you enjoy the session. If you have any doubts, as usual, mention it in the comment section. Thank you so much and good night.